Good day everybody, this is DoppelGameplayVideos and today we're playing Habitrail Hamster Ball. Yes, another Hamster Ball game because everybody loves Hamster Ball. They get tens of thousands or even hundreds of thousands or even millions of views. And everybody wants to see more. In fact, the vast majority of my subscribers are from Hamster Ball. So I'm pretty sure you guys will definitely enjoy this because you sure didn't enjoy the other ones. Not that it's a problem, you know. Everybody has different tastes and everybody loves Hamster Ball. So let's get this thing started. For this, we're gonna be playing advanced because beginner is easy mode. And here you choose a hamster and they're all identical. The only difference is the shirt and the voice. So let's start with the bedroom. Ooh. Everybody keeps their hamsters in their bedroom, right? Okay, we're gonna be playing normal game, please. Now, I don't know what's the difference between beginner and advanced. I think advanced has a little bit more obstacles. And right away, this game handles not very well compared to the other Hamster Ball games. There's a momentum system, as you can see with the little speed bar at the bottom, and the concept seems to be you have to move the stick very gently just to gain enough momentum to, you know, to complete the obstacles without flying off because of too much momentum. But I digress. The first levels is pretty easy. Or not. The first level is pretty easy with the obstacles being the flying saucers that will knock you over. And you get infinite lives. Yeah, infinite attempts, I mean. Okay, we almost hit the flying saucer over there. Oh crap! Okay, slow down. This makes the game very heavy and unresponsive, and the camera is pretty crap. First you get a view that is way too close, and then there's a slightly farther camera, and a really too far camera that's cuts off too much above you. So you don't know where, you can't see where you're going. But anyway, I think this, the medium distance camera, is the best. Okay, oh, there goes the flying saucer, about to knock me off the blocks. This is, of course, a normal European bedroom. Who doesn't have flying saucers in their bedrooms in the United Kingdom or Germany or France? Alright, once we finish the end, we get ourselves some living world triangles. And yes, that's an actual product you can buy in real life. They're advertising it. Alright, so let's continue. In fact, Habitrail is apparently a brand of hamster accessories, hamster cages, hamster tunnels, whatever you call these things. Oh yeah, the game was pretty much secondary. It's basically a ploy to get kids to buy, to get their family to buy stuff for their hamster. Okay, slow down. For this one, you have to like maintain momentum. Not too much momentum, so you fly off, but just enough momentum. I've only played like the first couple of levels just to test it out first, and. Okay, calm down. You can turn the camera around, but it's not like you can dual analog control on like the PS3 Hamster Ball. Alright. He gets his favorite Living World Triangle treats. Apparently this hamster's name is Herbie. Okay. Oh boy, ramps. Who doesn't love him? I think the main challenge right here is to maintain enough momentum to climb the Oh, I overshot. Whee! Okay, here we go. Down the hill, up the ramp. Oh yes. Make sure that your speed bar is nice and healthy in the red. Okay, cool. Oh no, we're losing speed. we're going backwards. Okay, catch up the speed. Turn up the speed. Red. Yes. Up and over the obstacle. Okay, looks like there's a loop in here. Aha! A tunnel. Okay, here it is. The finish line is approaching. Don't eat too many triangles, your pet will get fat. It's also weird that they made them anthropomorphic. Yeah, human-shaped hamsters. Okay, so now we're gonna go through this.
3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, turn. This momentum system really makes it hard to make sharp turns. It's like the... It's like the hamster ball is made out of solid lead. And you're really pushing hard against it to even get to start moving. Okay, upsy-daisy! Yeah! Okay, maintain momentum to get off! Too much momentum.
Oh no! 3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, turn right. The controls can definitely get used to the controls, that's for sure. Okay. We're losing too much speed bumping into those barriers. Too much speed!
Oh no! 3, 2, 1, go!
Okay. Turn around, go down. We're doing great! Just gotta maintain your momentum! Oh, I can see the finish line! Alright! It just took only 4 tries! Oh boy. Looks like we have traffic. And in fact, you can see. If you actually look around, you can actually see the cars fly over the gap. There. Thankfully, the cars don't seem to be very harmful instead of, like, pushing you backwards. They don't even have moving wheels. That's how low budget this game is. Okay. Oof. Oh, that's a wall of cars. Ah! Ah. Okay. They seem to be like Scalectrics toys. I used to have a Scalectrics kit as a kid, but we kind of lost them in a move. Hey, there's a finish line. That wasn't too hard. Living world triangles. Surely our hamster wants some variety in his food.